As a software developer, one of the things that has helped me excel really quickly in my career is having great mentors. And this is something that I do not take for granted, is having people who I can rely on when it comes to my career, when it comes to advice around it, and even technical advice. But this brings up the question that many of you ask me is, how do you find a mentor? How did I find my mentors? Today, I'm going to be sharing with you some of my tips and tricks around finding and building that relationship with a mentor, and not just any mentor, but a mentor that you really look up to, that you really truly want to emulate their career, that can help you build yours. And you know me, I'm a data person. I like to know around statistics and numbers. So I researched how important are mentors to other people to see if there was a survey done on this, and there was. And it's actually really interesting. 30% say it's very important to have a mentor, but a total of 47, almost 50% of people say it's important for them to have a mentor, or they want to have a mentor. That's a huge percentage of people who recognize and understand the importance of mentorship. But what's more interesting is 76% of people consider mentors important, but less than half have one right now. So why is that? We all know mentorship is so important, but why do so few of us have it? Well, in my experience, one of the main reasons is because people are scared to ask in the first place. A lot of times you are too scared to ask, will you be my mentor, or can I take you out for coffee? And that fear, I think it comes from the fear of rejection, fear of someone saying, you know what, no, I don't want to be your mentor, or I am too busy. But when you really take a step back and look at it, is it really that bad? Okay, let's get into my thoughts around this. And on the note of mentorship and forming relationships, I really wanted to share with you about a conference I am so excited to be part of, which is the Interact Conference 2022. It is happening October 25th, it is virtual, and the best part, it's completely free. I was part of their last conference, and honestly, hands down, it was the best conference I've ever attended. Listening to some incredible industry engineering leaders was so inspiring, and getting to interact with them, getting to ask questions, be part of this community, it was one of the best opportunities I've had to develop relationships with people for potential mentorships, and I think you can really benefit from it the same way. Here are some of the panel topics that will be covered: connecting your dev team's work to the business bottom line, being a leader in uncertain times, how to treat devs like human beings, and the science of building products for emerging industries. And yes, I mentioned learning and listening from some of the top engineering leaders. Some of them include Carolyn Vo, who is partner and head of engineering at Oliver Wyman, James Stanier, the director of engineering at Shopify, and Rukmini Reddy, who is the SVP of platform engineering at Slack, and more. Make sure to check their website for more announcements of upcoming speakers. Okay, so we spoke a little bit about the speakers, but some other top companies who will be attending include Stripe, Shopify, Slack, and more. One of my favorite things about this is it gives you access to the Dev Interrupted Discord channel. And this is a Discord channel that is filled with engineering leaders who bounce ideas off each other, who have questions for each other, and it's a great way to really connect with other leaders in the industry. Last thing that needs to be mentioned, there is giveaway and prizes. So I mean, it's free, it's virtual, there's giveaways and prizes. I don't think I need to say more. Anyways, make sure to join me there. There's a live chat, so make sure to say hi to me the day of the event.
And here is some more information about it. It is an all-day event, and yes, it will be recorded, but make sure not to miss the real thing, as there will be so much opportunities for networking and virtually meeting other people. Also, don't forget to tell your colleagues and your friends, this event is for everyone, it's completely free, so make sure to register.
I linked it down below, go sign up today. The first thing that you really need to ask yourself is why. Why do you want a mentor? And this is really important because there can be so many reasons why you want a mentor, whether it be for to help you with learning something new. For example, you are learning a new programming language and you need the support that a mentor can bring. Or maybe it's for the purpose of a career. You really want that support and guidance when it comes to your career. What are the best steps to take? What are the best companies to go to? There is so many different reasons that people get into relationships. Yeah, I guess it is a relationship with a mentor. And it's really important to establish the why as to why you are getting into a relationship with a mentor, because that will really determine or dictate as to how you approach them in the first place. And your why can change over time too. So what you have for a why today, don't feel as though you have to stay committed or set onto it. It can change as you continue to grow as well. But when you initially reach out to a mentor, it's important to have the why. Why do you want to meet with them? Why do you want to build this relationship with this person? after you have established why it is that you want to mentor in the first place, the next step is to reach out to them. And I'm going to add on screen here a little snippet that really helped me when I'm looking to reach out to someone and connect with them and maybe build a mentorship relationship. So pause here and you can screenshot this or save this for next time you're reaching out to a mentor. Okay, now that we got that part out, you have the why, you have reached out to them. Now, how do you go about building this relationship? Do you just straight up be like, be my mentor, this is what I want from you? No, it has to be a two-way street. And the best way to do that is it takes time. It needs to develop over time in an organic way. And on that note of building a relationship, it's something that takes time. It doesn't happen overnight. And the reality is you don't want to start reaching out to mentors or contacts when you actually need something or you really need their advice. You want to build that relationship prior, because there will come a time where you will need their help, where you will need their advice. And rather than doing it right when you actually need the advice, do it ahead of time. And what that will do is will build a genuine relationship. They're not going to be thinking, oh, this person's just reaching out to me because they need something again, or oh, here goes so-and-so needing something. No. You're building that relationship over time, and that is one of the biggest tips of pieces of advice that was given to me and that I always do is look at your future self. How could this help you in the future? And obviously you don't want to build relationships just based on what they can do for you. You want to build a two-way street, but don't just think about the now. Don't look so narrow, think so narrow-minded. Think about your future self and how what you are doing today, the relationships you are doing today, will help you in the long run. And on that note of relationships developing naturally and organically over time, I did a little bit more research around this. So I searched up, how did mentee and mentor relationships start? And it's really interesting. I'll pull up a graph here and it says 61% of the relationships developed naturally, which I think is really interesting because it doesn't have to be one of those things where you come right out and say, hey, can you be my mentor? No, it can start out with a, I'm interested in your career path. I want to emulate your career. Hey, I saw you worked X, Y, and Z. I saw you worked here. I want to work there. Or having this organic approach will really make it more of a two-way street to the mentor versus just, hey, can you be my mentor? Like, that's a very take mentality, and I think it needs to be more of a two-way street. And on that note, I think it goes without saying, but yet so many people don't do this, is after you have a call with someone, or even if you meet them in person, take time to send them a thank you note. It goes such a long way, and it's such an easy thing to do, yet so many people take it for granted how far it goes. I know for myself, if I meet with someone or have a coffee with someone, if they take the time to actually send a thank you note, it makes me feel so good, like, wow, they really appreciated my time. I went out of my day to speak to them, and they're acknowledging that. So send a thank you note, and send it in a timely manner. Send it right after or the same day that you meet with that person. And for those of you who are worried about constantly meeting, or I'm not saying you have to meet every week or every second day. Actually, according to this survey here, they surveyed over 3,000 individuals who are in corporate around mentorship, and the frequency of in-person meetings is less than once per month. So it's not as though you have to be meeting on a weekly basis, but the important thing is keeping the communication open, keeping the relationship flowing by letting them know what you are up to or asking different questions. And on that note of sending a thank you note, another thing that's really important is to maintain the relationship. It's not one of those things that you go out for coffee once, send a thank you note, and expect them to do the heavy lifting. No, you are the one who reached out to get this mentorship, to form this relationship, so you need to put in a little bit of work, and that needs to be on an ongoing basis. One of the things that I like to do a lot for maintaining or nurturing a new relationship is I will actually, some of the tips that they gave me throughout our coffee or our initial talk, I will of course put them into play and then let them know when I have done so. So for example, if someone says, oh, you should really read this article or check out this resource, I actually will do it. I mean, that's the whole point of this mentorship, this two-way kind of mentorship. And when I do it, when I do read these articles or whatever it is, a tip they have given me, I'll send a little note to them. I'll say, hey, so-and-so, I took time, read this article. Here are a few thoughts I have on that. And what it does is it keeps the dialogue open and the conversation moving. And it really makes the person who you are building that relationship up with to mentor you feel like, hey, so-and-so, Tiffany, or whomever it is actually taking what I'm saying and listening to it. They find it valuable. And that makes it almost feel like it's worth their time to meet with you more. And I've been talking a lot about this two-way relationship, but what exactly do I mean by it? At the end of the day, mentorship can become a life-changing opportunity. I know because it's completely changed my life in the sense of really helping me establish a sense of career, a sense of direction. And I really think you can do the same for you. It takes time and it takes effort, but with both of those things combined, like anything, you will find a great mentor and can really shape your career. Thank you all for watching. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career-related content. Also, make sure to join me at the Interact Conference. It's completely free to sign up. You should sign up today because there's a lot of great announcements that get made, a lot of great things to keep in track with, and I don't want to miss seeing you there. Linked down my bio, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.